Hello, this is Stampy, and welcome to a Minecraft Let's Play video. Another video inside of Stampy's lovely world. And it is an absolutely beautiful day today, and it actually looks like a beautiful day to play a spot of golf. In my last video, I said I was going to go and play golf with Alpha Lee, but unfortunately... Oh, hello, Lee. Oh, I love that little face thing. Yeah, I said I was going to play golf with Lee, but then something cropped up. I found a cat. I found a wild ocelot in my world, and I spent like, was it 24 minutes or something, trying to tame the one cat. And yeah, you were very stubborn, weren't you? Weren't you, girl? Weren't you very stubborn? Ah, but I absolutely love her, and I've come up with a name, and I'm going to announce it in a little bit, because I'm actually adding the person who came up with the name to my love garden. So we'll find that in a little bit. So yeah, in this video, I'm probably going to play with my cat for a little bit, and then we're going to go ahead to the golf course and play a spot of golf. And so yeah, let's get going. I don't need any breakfast. I actually sneaked up in the middle of the night. I went to the kitchen and actually stole some cake then. So I'm not hungry. Maybe we could have some cake for brunch. Oh, it's nothing against your cakes, Lee. Don't take it personally. I love your cakes. I'm just going to have one a little bit later on, okay? And oh, look at my cat. Just jumped up and sat on the bed. I didn't even tell it to sit down. Oh, that's adorable. I love my cat. Are you going to join me? It's just sitting on the bed. It won't come with us. Does it want to stay here? Do you not want to come with us? There we go. Oh, it's getting all excited. Well, it likes just jumping on the end of the bed. That's awesome. Anyway, let's go head over to my love garden and shout out the person that came up with the name. I suppose I might as well tell you the name now. And oh, good. Looks like some dirt fell out of a chest. Yeah, the name I've decided to call my cat is... Mittens! This is Mittens the cat. Two reasons. One, it's just a really cute name. Anyway, no! You stay back from Mittens. You leave Mittens alone. God, that spider came from nowhere. Yeah, I decided to call her Mittens. One, because it's just a really cute name for a cat anyway. And two, if you look at her paws, it kind of looks like she's wearing little mittens, like little white mittens. And so, yeah, I thought it was an absolutely perfect name for my cat. And the person who suggested that name was... I can't see because Lee Sword's in the way. You did that on purpose. You were trying to build up tension. It's Heath Mill is the person who left the comment on the video suggesting the name. And I got so many suggestions. I loved it. Within about, in about 24 hours of me uploading the video, I had over 8,000 comments, with the majority of them suggesting names. And I went through as many as I could. And there was loads of amazing names. There's so many like close like names that I almost called it. But in the end, I thought Mittens was the perfect name. But we've got a very important moment now, because I'm about to introduce Mittens to all the dogs, and they've not met yet. If you remember in the last video, when I was going out, I actually told Barnaby to sit down. So Mittens hasn't actually met any of the dogs yet, and not surprisingly, she's a little bit scared. You can see her staying behind me, moving a little bit tentatively. But trust me, all of my dogs are absolutely lovely, and hopefully you're all going to get on okay. Right, okay, so follow me in here, Mittens. Hopefully they're all going to get on, fingers crossed. Guys, doggies, I got a new friend for you all to meet, okay? Yeah, everyone look my way. Everyone look my way. I want you all to meet Mittens the cat. Oh, where is Mittens? Oh, here she is. Oh, she's gone straight for the doggy bath. Are they going to get one okay? Oh, look, she's made a friend. Oh, look, she's made a friend already. This is Duncan sitting down here. Oh, Mittens has already made a friend. Okay, Duncan, you can join us with this video straight away then, seeing as you guys are getting on so well. And oh, they all look quite excited. They all look quite excited, and they seem to be getting on very well. That's good. That is a weight of my mind, because yeah, if the dogs and the cats didn't get along, then we were going to have some issues. And what I'm going to need to do is build some sort of cat house, maybe like a cat cave or a... I've got actually in my Pick a Pet Pet Shop, I got a kitty cat corner where I was going to put a cat for sale, but I don't feel like selling Mittens right now. I've only just got one cat, and it feels kind of mean getting a cat then immediately just putting her in my pet shop and then kind of ignoring her. So I'm going to wait until I've got a few more cats, and then maybe I'm going to put one in the Pick a Pet Pet Shop just to be a display model. I'm not actually going to get rid of any of my cats, and I already want more. This is just what happened to my dogs. I found one dog, I fell in love with him, and then every wild dog I saw, I tried to get them. And I already want that with the cats. Now I've got one cat. I think I'm going to end up getting addicted to cats like I did to dogs and try and get as many as I can. They're really good though, because... Excuse me, Duncan, what are you trying to do? I'm trying to get up the ladder. If I can jump over him... Come on, Duncan, you go up the ladder, then I'll follow after you, okay? Go on, I'm trying to push him up. Duncan, come on, there we go. We're going up together. And there we go, Duncan. Lee, you had a dog on your head. As you were growing up, I just saw the dog balancing on your head. Is that a new hat? It suits you. Oh, dear. Oh, I completely forgot what I was going to say now. I was talking about cats or dogs or something. Sorry, I've completely lost track. My bad. Anyway, it doesn't matter. We're at the golf course. We got all four of us here at the golf course. We can have a big game of golf together. And so, yeah, what we're going to do is we're going to take it in turns. And the way the golf works is you throw the first ball down, and then wherever it stops, you then need to go and stand wherever it stops and throw the next one. And yeah, it's whoever can do it in the least throws. And we're going to take it in turns. And basically, rather than keeping count of all of the throws, we're going to just see who won each hole. So do you want to go firstly? Do you want to do the first throw? And this one should be very easy. This one is called Noob Alley. So if you miss this one, then yeah, you're an absolute noob. So yeah, no pressure, Lee. And no pressure indeed. He got it in. One straight throw. Very easy. Let me go do the same, hopefully. And there we go. So we got a draw. So I won't bother writing down any points for that. I'm going to be doing a little tally as we go. This one's a bit harder. This one's called The Dip. So he needs to throw it down here, avoid the pieces of wall. And yeah, the hole is actually all the way down there. And oh, that's a good throw. Oh, he's got it down to the second level. That is a very good throw. You can tell that Lee has certainly played this game before. And now he's just going to drop it in. Easy peasy. I think that's pretty much the best you can do. So all I need to do is make sure I can match him. So I'm going to go and try and copy his technique. If I jump and throw, there we go, big throw. Am I going to get it down? Oh no, not quite as good as his first throw. I should still definitely be able to get it in if I just go plop. Easy peasy. Didn't even touch the sides. I got a swish with that one. And look at Mittens there sitting on the chest in the corner. Oh, she's so cute. I love having a cat. It's like a fellow kind, you know. I finally got another cat in this world. It was dominated by dogs, bears and squids, and now I've got a fellow feline. A fellow feline. I like that. Anyway, Lee, take it away. Sorry, I am watching. I am watching, I promise. So that's one throw. I think this one you can get it in two, but I think you need to throw it over Gregory Jr.'s head. So yeah, if you want to put a helmet on or something, Gregory Jr., if you want to duck. Oh, nicely done, straight over. Right, I guess I'm gonna go and try and do the same then, shall I? Oh look, Mittens has come to watch. Mittens got bored on the chest. Right, throw number one. Oh, it didn't go very far. That didn't go very far. I'm gonna wait for a little bit, make sure it's completely stopped. I need to stand on this block and try and throw it over Gregory Jr.'s head. Right, watch out, Gregory Jr., shut your eyes, and yeah, I got it in. So we're still drawing. We are still neck and neck. This is getting quite tense actually, isn't it? Right, now time for Cobblestone Castle, this one's called. And this one's very difficult because you need to time it for when the ice block there goes down. You also need to watch out for cats that can walk across the thing. No, you got to go anyway, Lee. You can still get it in if you just, yeah, try and avoid my new cat if you can. This one's really difficult. And no, he did it. He did it. Oh, no, I always fail at this one. Oh, he didn't get a hole in one in, though. Lee, look how close that is. Look how close to the edge. You got it. You got to throw again. You got to go and try and drop it down that last bit. There we go, nicely done. So once again, I could actually beat him here though. Actually, I think I could get a hole in one if I time this perfectly and get it far enough. And be careful, Mittens, do not get stuck in that. No, Mittens, you stay away. Mittens trying to get through. What's that? Mittens got like lifted through. Anyway, let's go, let's try and time it. If I throw it now, go. What happened then? It was down, but it still didn't go through. I could still do this. I could still get this in on this next throw and still get the draw. Come on, come on, come on. Go. Is it going to go in? Can I hear the ding? No, there's no ding. Oh, is it going to go? Oh, no, look how close that is. Oh, go on, Mittens. Just knock it. Just turn around and flick it in with your tail. No, I've lost. Well, I've lost this hole, which means Lee is now up by 1 point above me. So we drew in all of them up until now. So Lee has a 1 point lead. And oh, Mittens, sit down. Sit down, Mittens, okay. Kittens do not go well with fire. So for now, Mittens, you can stay sitting there. And once we're past this hole, you can carry on. Okay, Lee, do you want to take it away? I don't know if he's already thrown it yet, and I don't think he has. Right, if you want to take your first throw? Now, this one's quite difficult. There's three holes to choose from, and they all lead to somewhere else. And oh no, that was a bad throw. He's gone straight in the soul sand. This is my chance to try and get level peggings with him again. Okay, Lee. Oh, he's gone for the middle hole. He's gone for the middle hole, and that should make the ball drop out in the middle there, I believe, if I'm correct. Yeah, there we go. I can see the slime ball coming out now. Do you think he's got an advantage? Do you think because he's got a slimy one that it makes it roll further? So that's two throws so far. So we got it in three throws. That's a very good showing, actually. That's not bad. But you can If you get right on the very edge of this block, I want to make sure I'm not cheating. You need to be on the black. But there we go, right on the edge of the block. I can throw it over that soul sand and maybe get it in one. If I get a good 45 degree angle and... Gah! Can I go, 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 go? Please drop in, please drop in. No! Look at that! I've had the most unlucky game ever. It's like hovering over the edge. You're lucky, Lee. You're lucky. Right. All I need to do now is make sure I drop it in here. Drop it in. No! It did go in. I thought that wasn't going to go in then. I panicked then. Right. I can still draw. If I get it in my next throw, then we've drawn on this hole. And he'll still be up by 1 point overall. But things won't be looking quite as dire for me as they are right now. Right, here we go. My golf ball has come out here. This is a bit harder than his throw, but it's still very doable if I go and get a big throw. And straight in. Easy peasy. So, yeah, Lee's still up by 1 point. And now we're on to the next hole, which is called the Littlewood. And it's kind of like a little enchanted forest down here. There's lots of flowers and glowstone underneath and the big mushroom. I like this hole. This is quite a pretty hole. And so there's Lee's first throw. You can, if you've got lots of skill and you curve the ball well, get this in just two throws. You need to kind of bounce it off the tree. And he's done it. He's done it in just two throws. Have you been up all night? Last night, I went up to Lee's room and he wasn't there. I think he came down here and he was practicing all night just to try and beat me. He's doing very well. He's certainly piling on the pressure. Right, let's try and match Lee then, shall we? Right, I got a big throw there. Get it as far forward as I can. Well, that might be too far forward, actually. Right, I need to try and bounce it off that tree. I need to avoid the mushroom. There's not mushroom here. Right, let's go and try and get it in. Oh, that was a bad throw. Go, go, go. Yes, I managed to draw again. So Lee is still winning by 1 point, but it is only 1 point. And this is quite a cool one, actually. This is called the mine shaft. And what you need to do is... Oh, no, there's a creeper. There's a creeper. Wait, 1 second, Lee. Hold the game. Pause the game. I got my priorities here. You can see Duncan sitting there. He's just not interested whatsoever. This is where I need mittens. Cats actually do scare away creepers. So, having mittens close by would help. I'll go grab her in a little bit. Anyway, take your first throw, Lee. I'm not entirely sure how many you can do this in. I think you might be able to make it in maybe four throws is the best you can do, because you drop it down that hole there and then you go down and carry on underneath. So there we go, he's done two throws so far, and so I think you can do it in two more throws and that will be perfect. So good luck, Lee, good luck. Right, so yeah, he needs to get it down into the hole, which is right down at the end there. So yeah, that is where he's trying to get it to there. I'll try and stay out your way, Lee. Take your third throw. Oh, he's done this very well. I think he's done this just about as well as you can do. If he gets it in now, I think that might have been the perfect round of golf. And he's done it as well. He is refusing to make a mistake. That one small mistake from me is going to be the big, massive difference maker. And what are you doing? No googlies on the golf course. Thank you very much. There we go. Okay, Lee. Watch my back, Lee, as I take this. I don't want to get blown up by anything as I'm trying to play golf. Right, so he did it in four. I think the best I can do is match him. So, big throw. Throw number one. That was good. That was good. Oh, that's got really far. That was, like, perfect. So, throw number one. Throw number two. Then I've got to hop down here. I love this little hole. It's quite cool. I know I built it. I don't want to sound big-headed, but it is quite cool. So there's two throws there. And if I stand here, I need to get it to the left of that pillar if I can. Throw number three. Big jump. Go, 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 go. Oh, no. I got it stuck. I didn't get as far as him. Oh, got stuck on a little block there. I might still be able to draw with him, though. If I get this in perfectly here, I might still draw. And I got it. Look at that. Long range putt. Stampy long nose. Check me out. So he's still winning. I'm still losing. But this is the most difficult hole coming up now. We are now about to play Hungry Stampy. And what you're going to do is you're going to try and throw the ball and you're going to get it into the big mouth of me over there. You're basically going to feed me because I'm very hungry. I'm trying to eat the cake, but I just about can't reach it. So you've got to throw it through my mouth and there's actually a hole inside. And oh, that was a good throw by Lee. The problem is if it goes in the water, it gets pushed all the way back to the beginning. So you've got to be very careful. And he did that really well. I think he has been practicing. He is doing very, very well. Oh, he's done it almost perfectly. He's got it right onto the cake. So that's two throws so far. Oh, and then he stood on the cake. Someone was going to eat that. So that's three throws. I think you might have actually been able to do that in two. I think you could have. So I've actually got a chance to win here. And so this is throw number 4. And oh no, it didn't go in. It didn't go in, Lee. It's right on the edge. It didn't go in. I was so sure it was going to go in. Oh no, this is my chance. If I win here, then I'll be able to draw. The best I can do is draw, but at least I can do that. Right, do you want to finish it off, Lee? You still got one more throw just to go and put it in, just to make it official. There we go. He didn't muck that up. So that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 throws he did it in. I think I might be able to do this in 4. Right, everybody wish me luck. You need to make sure it doesn't go into the water because it's really hard to get it out. So if I go like that, there's throw number 1. Oh, don't go in the water! Don't go in the water! Don't go in the water! Ooh! I saw there Lee willing for it to go and just drop in. Right, throw number 1. I want to try if I can to get it past the cake. So throw number 2! Big throw! Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! Curve around! That was good! I got it all the way to the mouth in 2. I might actually be able to just get this in 3 throws. And I've still got a spare one after this. Right, get it in! Drop in! No, it didn't drop in. It didn't drop in, but I can still win. If I throw it in now, I can still beat Lee. Well, at least draw with him. And yes, we drew. We truly, you got to be happy with that. That was a good game. You were winning for almost the entire time. And in the very last hole, I managed to catch up and draw. I actually remember the only other time I've played this in a video, I was playing against Chloe or Epic Big C. And yeah, we drew as well. So I guess that, yeah, there's a lot of people that draw playing this. Anyway, Mittens, be very careful of the fire. We're going to head off now. And oh no! Oh no, Duncan! Oh no, Duncan! Quick, give him pork chops! Give him pork chops! Quick, quick, quick! Oh, watch out for Mittens as well. Oh, come here! Come here, Duncan! Eat the pork chops! Eat the pork chops! Don't scare me like that! Quick, get Mittens away! Everyone away from the fire! All animals! Oh, there's a creeper! There's a creeper! There's a creeper! No! Oh no! Oh dear, I was not ready for that. Oh no, at least I only broke a bit of the path. Mittens, welcome to life inside a Stampy's lovely world. You better get used to things like that happening because it happens all the time. Anyway, very quickly before the end of the video, we're going to head over to Flower Power and we're going to have a 1v1 game on that. Seen as we haven't played it in quite a while, we thought it would be quite good fun. So I'm going to be on the Sunkiss team, and Lee's going to go and represent the lovely, jubbly, love petals. And we've got to be quick because we need to set our spawns before it's morning. And yeah, if you've not seen this before, you basically got to go and capture flowers. You've got to run around, you've got to grab as many flowers as you can and bring them back to your base. And the first player to get all 4 flowers is going to win. So what I need to do is tell Duncan and Mittens to sit down, because I don't want Duncan to go after Lee. Actually, Duncan, do you want to head over here a little bit? Yeah, just so, yeah, if I hit Lee, I don't want Duncan to go crazy and try and go after him. You need to get empty all of your pockets. You need to go and put them in the chest out here. Just so you're not carrying a load of things on you. And also make sure you take your armor off as well, Lee, just so you don't have any unfair advantages. Because we can only use wooden swords and bows and arrows is all we can use. So I might as well grab my bow and arrow from here. And yeah, let's go to bed. And then in the morning, we can play Flower Power. I love this game. Like, I had one big like video where we played it loads. We had a big tournament and I was actually able to win that. And I've not really played it since then. So I'm looking forward to going to have another go to go and play it again. Right. If you're ready, Lee, I'm going to pull the lever and we'll start the game in 3, 2, 1. Go, 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 go. And we are off. I don't know where he's going to be going. Oh, he's gone up top. He's gone up top. See if I can hit him with an arrow. Oh, did that hit him? If that didn't hit him, that was very close. And you can pick up the flowers from both your side and the other side. I'm going to go in and attack him though. I'm going to go in and be very aggressive and try and go after him. Oh, he got some good hits on me there. Oh, he destroyed me. No, this is not good. Right, get another bow and arrow if I can and go and grab a sword. Oh, this was a bad start. This was a bad, bad start. Because I won the last game, he is after revenge. He's trying to go after me. He's trying to prove a point that he is the best person at Flower Power in all the land. I want to retain my title, so I need to try and get all of the yellow flowers and try and bring them back to my base if I can. I know he's picked up one of his own red flowers, to try and stop me. Right, I've managed to get 2 of them. I've managed to get 2 of them. I don't think he knows where I am. If I try and get a few shots on him, there we go, I got a good shot with the arrow. I get a few good more. Oh, he's stuck in the corner down there. He has nowhere to run. I can get him trapped. Oh, he's trying to go. I got another good shot though, another good shot. Oh, he's running after me. I think, oh no, he's trying to get away. I think he's gonna try and get back onto his base. You're not allowed to go inside of your base. you're allowed to go on top of it, but not inside. Right, I'm going to chase him down. This is a good chance. There we go. I managed to get him. I've got two flowers now. I got two yellow flowers, and I need four to win. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go bank these flowers. Once you place them down, they're not allowed to pick them back up again, and I can see him chasing after me. It's too late, Lee. It's too late. They are down. I have put them down. Right, if I try and shoot him with an arrow, get him back. Oh, he shot me fire flying there. Try and hit him again. No. He got me. Okay, at least I've got two flowers in. Right, go and grab my stuff as quick as I can. I can hear Mittens cheering me on from outside. Quick, I need to make sure he doesn't get all my flowers. Oh, he's got that one from there, and he's got that one from there. Oh, which ones hasn't he got? Which ones are my... Oh, he hasn't got this one down here. That's okay. I'm not out of the game yet. I am not out of the game. Oh, this is scary. He's going to be hunting me down like crazy, though. I need to just try and stay alive. Where is he? Oh, he's right there. Oh, no, he's hitting me. Oh, I got another good shot. I didn't hit him, though. Oh, no, he's going to take me out. I need to run. No, please don't kill me, Lee. See mercy, Lee. Please see mercy. I've been good to you, haven't I, Lee? Haven't I been good to you? Please don't kill me. I can just hide here and let my health go up. Oh, God, that was so close. That was so close. Oh, he's coming. He's coming after me. No, he got me. No, he managed to get me. Right, I just need to go grab my sword if I can. I can actually climb up here and get straight back to where I was. Here we go. I can go after him. There we go. I managed to take him out. And he had both of his flowers. And I can put them down. And I have won. Yes. 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 Oh, man, that was epic. What an ending. What an ending to the game. Oh, let me... If I had a hat on, Lee, I'd take it off to you. Because that was an epic battle. We had three... I think he only needed this one last red flower and he would have won. That was awesome. well played, sir. Well played, sir. Oh, what an amazing video. That was so much fun. It's nice going back to playing some of these old games that I built a little while ago. And I'm loving having Mittens with me as well. I'm loving having my own cat. And where is Mittens? I feel like I should have played with Mittens a little bit more this video. And oh, look, she's up here sitting on the little chest outside. Maybe in the next video, we'll go and catch you some fish and maybe give you a glass of milk and some string to play with. And eventually, one day I'm going to build you a house. But for now, you can carry on sleeping on the end of my bed. Anyway, that's going to be the end of this video here. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. As always, there'll be a link in the description to the next part of my Let's Play once it's online. So thanks for watching, everybody, and I will see you later. Bye!